he has a column today on Town Hall, no to DC statehood. And they're throwing so much stuff at us. Now they're talking today, they're talking about executive order on so-called gun control. There's HR 1, which would just federalize the election system and, you know, make it impossible for honest elections to be held in the United States. There's the Green New Deal, the shutting down the Keystone Pipeline. It doesn't end. But one of the really bad ideas, and we try to take these ideas, one every couple of days just to keep you informed, is, and they're having hearings on it already, that's they want to give statehood to the District of Columbia in Puerto Rico. And David Harsanyi wrote a column about it today, no to DC statehood. Dave Harsanyi, thanks for being with us here on the Howie Carr Show.
Always a pleasure. Thanks for having me.
Well, why is this a bad idea?
Well, it's a bad idea, especially in the case of DC statehood, because the Washington DC, the federal district, was created specifically not to be a state, specifically not to be in a state, because this is the center of power in the country. And what you would have would be two senators voting to empower the federal government. States made the federal government. They're not beholden to the federal government. I know a lot of people don't realize that today. So it's a terrible idea. And the only reason Democrats are interested in doing it right now is because they want two more senators to try to gain more power. There's no real good other reason for it.
Right. I mean, my understanding, I didn't know this until recently, but when they put in Hawaii and Alaska at basically the same time back in the late 1950s, they figured Hawaii would be a Democrat state and Alaska would be a Republican state. So it kind of balanced it out. Kind of like, when Missouri wanted to join the Union, they said, we don't have a free state, so let's split Maine off from Massachusetts and we'll keep the balance. Now, in this case, the Democrats want to upset the balance of power, don't they? It's the opposite of what the way states are usually added to the Union.
Yeah, absolutely. If they would be in favor of adding, American Samoa or someplace that voted Republican, I don't know that they do. I'm just throwing something out there.
Guam.
And said, let's add two states.
It would be a different story,
right? But it's a partisan thing. And you know what? That's fine. Then let's have a partisan argument. If you want to talk about partisanship, even initially, James Madison wrote about Washington in a partisan way. He said that he was worried that people who live there would empower the government, but he also worried that that the government would have to live under an antagonistic state. Meaning, if it's a democratic state now and you have a Republican government, it's going to undermine the federal government as well. It doesn't work. That's why they made DC especially to be what it is. Now, if you want to shrink it maybe and let people, be in Maryland or Virginia or whatever and vote with there, that doesn't really bother me. But it, to create a new state, I think, is just a naked power grab.
Right. And isn't it in the Constitution that there will be this district set up that is not a state? So wouldn't this require a constitutional amendment rather than just a straight party line vote after you abolish the filibuster?
Yeah, I think it would. I mean, there's some argument about that, but the Justice Department under many different presidents and Democratic presidents says you would need to change the Constitution. So it's never really going to happen. This is just part of a larger argument to make Republicans look like they're anti-democracy and they don't want to give people the right to vote and, things like that. So I think it's just really part of that whole, effort.
But it's scary. I mean, all this stuff coming at you day after day after day. I mean, HR 1 is frightening what they're proposing to do there. You're relying on one or two senators, a guy like Manchin, and then now Manchin's wife gets some big appointive job as to the head of some Appalachian Regional Commission, which I guess is a big deal in West Virginia. And, I mean, it's, if you're just sitting out here in flyover country, David, we worry about stuff like this.
No, everyone should be worried because they're trying to fundamentally change how America works. They want it to be a majoritarian, centralized, direct style democracy, which is not what the founders wanted, which is not what America is about. We have states for a reason. They don't like states. And it's just the truth of it. They want to destroy sort of the checks and balances that we have, where states and people can live their own lives. Like, I don't want to force people to do things, but I don't want to be forced either. And I think having a voice in minority government, the filibuster, for instance, is incredibly important in upkeeping, you know, the founders' vision for how the country worked. I know the filibuster is not in the Constitution, but I can assure you that the founders never, ever imagined something like H.R. 1 being put forward, where the federal government would take over the elections of all the states and make them do all kinds of religious, you know, ridiculous election integrity destroying stuff, right? So, yeah, the filibuster is super important.
And they were going to let the and this also includes, I mean, there's 791 pages. So I don't think anyone knows what everything that's in there. But there's something to discipline the Supreme Court. I don't think the founding fathers ever anticipated that the executive would be allowed to appoint unelected bureaucrats who would then discipline the Supreme Court. I don't think that's part of the checks and balances that they envisioned, is it?
No. And I mean, you know, most people don't know who I am, but I am not one who panics about stuff or like says this is the end of democracy and things like that. But I'm just saying, I think H.R. 1 is one of the most authoritarian bills that has ever been in Congress. It completely nationalizes elections. It forces states to do all kinds of crazy things, like 10 days after an election voting and not allowing states to have, you know, photo IDs and allowing felons to vote. Now, if you want to do that in your own state, that's fine, but not the federal government. But on top of that, there's all kinds of free speech undermining stuff in there as well that we don't talk about, that is just horrible. I just can't even imagine it would stand up in the Supreme Court.
Yeah, but, you know, again, they're afraid. I think that's why that provision is in there, to discipline the Supreme Court. And they're just trying. It's just pure hardball, you know, bare knuckles, not even politics. It's just authoritarian. I like the fact that you said too, though, that this, the Democrats are trying to localize one of the only things in the Constitution that is actually federalized, while they federalize everything else, in H.R. 1 being the most prominent example of it. But there are others as well. I mean, you know, it's like, there's a guy in D.C., Chris Plant, and he always says, the Democrats want to make everything mandatory that isn't outlawed. And this is another example of it, isn't it?
Yeah. Yeah. I mean, it's like they use words like loophole. Loophole just means there's no law that they want to exist in that spot, right? Or they say voter restrictions, which means just anything that they come up with, you have to allow them to do, or it's the next Jim Crow. I think it's a bad time, and I don't think that this is going to work out for them in the long run, because I still have enough faith still in the American people to say that, you know, I just can't imagine they would go along with something like H.R. 1. So, you know, we'll see what happens. But I mean, this is the farthest left that we've ever seen a party, and it's not even close.
Yeah, I agree. You know, another thing that gets me about this, the argument that's made, well, D.C., it's taxation without representation. But the irony there, of course, is that the Beltway area has, I believe, 7 out of the 10 most affluent counties in the United States. I mean, this is the richest area in the country. And I hate to say it, but, you know, you live there, I think, David, but it doesn't produce anything. It just takes. It takes from the rest of the country, from the people who provide goods and services. And now they're claiming that they have no representation, that they're taxed. We're the ones who are taxed with no representation, more than them, I would say.
People in Washington, and I do live around here, unfortunately, they are the most powerful people in the world. They live off the taxes of the rest of the nation. They should not be able to tax everyone more to become richer. It's bad enough what's going on in Maryland and in Virginia, Northern Virginia, that now we're going to create another million people who get to do that. And they do it anyway, by the way. But so, yeah, I mean, you're right about that.
Yeah, I don't know. It's really tough. It really is a scary time in the United States. I'm like you. I try not to depress people, and I try not to claim the sky is falling at all times. But you got to keep presenting people the threats that are out there. You know, I mean, believe it or not, DC statehood is kind of a minor threat compared to the other things they've got up their sleeve
at
this point.
I agree. Ugh. You know, it's like I thought to myself the other day, I'm constantly writing the same column about guns, right? Because they keep doing the same things on guns. So I have to write that column. And I think it's important to be vigilant and not let them get away with it.
Yeah. We had a case in Boston today. A guy tried to rob a convenience store and he stole a police car and he got the rifle out of the police car and was coming out of the car and they shot him, right? A rifle. Right. So 3 days ago, you know where I'm going with this, David. 3 days ago, a rifle was a weapon of war. Right. It had to be outlawed. Now, the same people who were talking about the weapon of war in Boston 3 days ago are saying, why did the police have to shoot that guy? He just had a rifle.
Yeah. But they may also say, like, you know, it's a weapon of war, which it's not an AR-15. And then on the other hand, they're like, you will never be able to stand up to the government anyway. Why do you need it? You know, but it's also a weapon of war. Well, how can it be both those things? Also, have you ever heard of Vietnam or, you know, a million other sort of small bore wars? Now, I'm not saying we're going to have a revolution or anything, but I mean, that's the point of having those sorts of guns, right?
Right.
But their arguments don't make sense because, frankly, they're mostly emotion and right. Emotionally driven. And it's very powerful, you know, so you have to kind of start to fight back against that, but you have to keep doing it.
Yeah. No, you just have to point out how ridiculous it is that the same people who are saying, why did they shoot this guy with a rifle 3 days ago, were saying it was the most deadly weapon the humans had ever had. But it's just, it's a strange time we're in. And David Harsanyi, thanks for being with us. It's a great column, No to DC Statehood, and it's on Town Hall. We'll tweet it out. Thank you, David. It's officially spring, and that means allergy season is back. Fortunately, so is the Eden Pure Thunderstorm Air Purifier BOGO offer. Buy one, get one free BOGO. That's right, BOGO is back for this week only until Sunday, March 28th. As warmer temperatures arrive, you're going to want to open those doors and windows. Open doors and windows mean pollen inside, and more pollen means even more need for the Thunderstorm Air Purifier. One user wrote, the Thunderstorm does just what it claims. It definitely is effective on my husband's allergies, sneezing, runny nose, and coughing.
Unquote. Howie, we made it very easy for a lot of our listeners today to get this deal. We sent out a text message that had the link in it to get the Howie Carr BOGO deal at EdenPure.com. If you didn't get it, you need to text Howie to 635-66, and you can get any future text messages, which may contain deals. But today, we sent out a big text, so a lot of people... Just check your phone. You could get this deal right now.
And are we going to let people know about Cheap Bastard deals in the future?
We'll see. But right now, it was just this deal today. Cheap Bastard okay. deals, we'll see.
All right. The Thunderstorm is a small device you can hold in your hand, as I'm doing right now. You plug it into your electrical outlet or into your car by USB cable to purify the air. And with BOGO, each Thunderstorm costs well under $100. The Thunderstorm air purifier works like a real thunderstorm. It quietly sends out super oxygen and ions to kill odors in your room and purify the air. To handle pollen or those unwanted odors from pets, cooking, musty basements, tobacco, or anything else, you need the Thunderstorm. Buy one, get one free. BOGO. The more you buy, the more you save, and there are no limits. But only for this week. Go to EdenPure.com, click on the radio banner, and use code word Howie BOGO at checkout. That's EdenPure.com radio banner and code word Howie BOGO. With BOGO, your problem rooms will no longer be a problem. I'm Howie Carr.
The Howie Carr Show.
This hour of the Howie Carr Show was brought to you in part by Ken's Place,